This video is just a short extract from the entire course. If you wish to see all of the videos from this series at higher quality and in far larger screen size, head over to ifskills.com.
So during the build of your database and your table, you make sure you have the correct field names, you make sure you have the correct data types, and then as well as choosing the correct data type, there are a number of field properties that allow you to, in some degree, customize that data type. Let's use the addressbook_fieldproperties database, available in your working folder, to just explore some of those field properties. We take our contacts table, right click and design view. We can see all of our fields and the data types chosen. You will find that in this copy of the database, I've actually added another field here called number of children, really just so that we get a number field so we can explore the different number types. Now, choosing the first field, field name, as well as choosing the data type here on the right, in the bottom section, we have a set of field properties. Now you'll find that as you move down the list, these field properties change to now look at the field you've selected in the top. So these field properties are the properties for the street field. If we choose telephone, these field properties are now the field properties for the telephone field. And likewise for the web, these are the field properties for the web field. So choosing the first name one first, we're not actually going to look at every single field here, we're just going to concentrate on where the field properties differ. For a text data type, these are the field properties. We can control the field size, and that is number of characters. Now you'll find in any of these properties that you click into, you'll get a little bit of help on the right there that can just sometimes give you a little bit of edge, a little bit of notice. Field size controls how many characters this field will accept as a maximum. By default, it's 255, and that is actually the maximum. So when you choose the field data type, Access assumes you want to make use of the full possible size of that field. Now you can restrict the field size, and that could help with the data entry so that you're not getting too much extraneous data. How many people's first name do you know that require 255 characters? Personally, I know none, so I'm going to reduce that to 25. Then we have a format option. This will actually format the text in the table. This is completely non-required if you're going to build your Access database to use forms and reports, because the form and the report will therefore control the formatting. The advantage to doing the formatting in the form or the report is that that is an instruction to the database at the time it needs it. If you tell this database to format the first name field, it has to format all the records. So if you have 3,500 records, they all now hold formatting, and that will double the file size of the database. So keep all the formatting for the forms and the reports, where effectively it's going to be required for either formatting on the screen or formatting out on a piece of paper or a PDF. The input mask controls how the text can be typed in, and we explore the input mask separately in the next lesson. The caption, this is an important bit. This is the label that will be used for this field on forms, reports, and even on the column heading in tables instead of the field name. So I've said that field names ought not to have spaces in them to make the programming slightly easier in the longer term, but your caption, this is used only by Access, can have those spaces in. So I could put a caption in of first name and have a space in there. And then wherever Access uses this field, it will also put a label, and that label will have first space name. Now, if a field has a field name that is acceptable, so for example, surname is fine, then leave the caption blank and Access will use the field name. So the caption is only required for field names that you might decide are a little bit cryptic. I might make my field names even shorter. I would tend to call that FN and SN. That way the caption is vitally important. So it becomes first name there and surname there. Let's go back to the FN field, which has a caption of first name. So we can control the field size, maximum number of characters. We could format the field, but I'm going to suggest that you don't ever. Input mask we're going to look at separately. Caption is the label to be used by Access whenever it uses this field. So that label will appear in forms, reports, and tables. The default value, if any of your fields are likely to have pretty much the same value in for a lot of the entries, you could set a default value. and that value then will be entered into that field already before anyone types a new value in. As an example, country. A lot of my friends in this address book might live in the United States, so I could set a default value of USA. That way, you notice when I clicked away that Access put speech marks around it as well because it's a text value. That way, when I go to enter a new record, it will already have USA in the country. And if I don't want USA, I overtype. If I do want USA, I can just carry on and tab through and the USA will already be there. That's the default value. Not all fields are appropriate to have default values, but some are, like the country. Then we have a validation rule and a validation text. And again, we will look at these in a separate lesson. Then we have an option for required. It has a drop down. The only choices there is yes or no. Is this field a required field? Now, the temptation is to make all of your fields required, but when that comes to then data entry, that can be a nightmare. Perhaps you don't have the person's first name at that moment in time. Perhaps you don't have their region. Perhaps you don't have their zip code. So although it's a great option to have, use it sparingly and choose it for fields that you really must have that data for. Otherwise, you'll find that people just put anything in. They'll just make it up just so that they can get past the requirement of it being there. Because I want my address book to be full and entire and correct for posting things out, I'm going to make the zip code, so if I choose that field, a required field, so from no to yes. You will find that with these options where there is a drop down, if you double click, it will run through the drop down options. Now there's only two here, yes or no, so double click, change me back to a yes, double click, change me back to a no. So I want to make the postcode field a yes. Whilst I'm in the postcode zip field, let's change the field size right down to 15. So back to the first name to carry on exploring. The first name I'm not going to change to a yes field. Then we have the option to allow zero length, and that is a yes or a no. As far as Access is concerned, this will make no difference whether you make yes or no. The only time it will make a difference is again when we move forward and perhaps look at doing some programming with your database, where being null and being zero length are different things. Access treats them the same. Now the default is yes, so we could just live with the default. Indexed is no, and then there are two yes options. Yes with duplicates being okay, yes with no duplicates. Now we're going to leave indexing as no. Only a few fields would be indexed, and indexing is looked at much later on in this course. Unicode compression, again it's a yes-no option. I would leave it as yes. It's to do with the way that Access will compress characters, so any compression is good. The IME mode and the IME sentence mode, I would leave as the default, which is no control and none. These tell Access how to deal with Far East languages and Japanese language characters. Now you'll find in the appendix right at the end, I've put a reference for the Microsoft website that explains what each of the options do if you need to deal with characters from Far Eastern languages and Japanese languages. Now smart tags, the last option in here, are tags that you've generated to use with the rest of Microsoft Office, and you can link them to this field. Smart tags are outside the remit of the foundation course. So in reality, we're interested in really anything from indexed upwards, because we're going to leave Unicode as yes, leave the IME as their default, and then smart tags as empty. So we need to choose whether we're going to index a text field, whether we allow zero length, and again, that's really to be left as default. Whether a field is required or not, whether you're going to set a default value, whether you require a caption, input mass we look at separately, and the maximum field size. So that's for a text field. And all text fields have the same properties down this left-hand side, but you will most likely assign them different values. Now, each of the other data types has slightly different field properties, but some in similar. Let's take the number of children, for example. It still has input mask, caption, default value, validation, rule and text, and required and indexed. But its field size is not to do with how many characters you can get in a field, but the physical size of the number and how much space it takes. And the choices in the dropdown are byte, integer, long integer, single, double, replication ID, or decimal. Well, replication ID you can ignore because that's to do with replicating databases, and that's not going to be a problem for anything in the foundation course. The other number types determine how much memory space the number uses, and therefore the size of the number that is available to use. Bear in mind that integer and long integer will only hold whole numbers, which is actually fine for our number of children. Byte can only hold a number between 1 and 255. Single and double can hold large and larger numbers with decimal places. Now, the actual breakdown of the exact number that each of these can hold is available on Microsoft Access website, but roughly, single and integer can hold a number from -32,000 to +32,000, and long integer and double can hold a number from -2 billion to +2 billion. Now, decimal is a new addition to the number choices and will allow you to hold a decimal number, so with decimal places, very much like single and double can, and a slightly larger range of numbers. But when it comes to numbers, it's not just any good saying, yeah, it's a number data type. You then need to decide, well, what kind of number? Am I only dealing with whole numbers? Do I need to be able to put decimal places in? If so, do I need to be able to put large numbers in or smaller numbers in? Now, when it comes to the case of children, children are whole numbers, so that would be an integer. Well, actually, a byte, because you're not going to have negative children. You might have negative children, but you won't have a negative number of them. And you're not really like to have more than 255 unless you happen to be holding information on rabbits. So byte would be enough space to hold the number of children for each of our friends. Format would control the formatting of the number, and you'll find that that allows you to then decide whether you want decimal places, whether it's a currency, whether it's fixed, whether it's standard, whether it's percentage, or if it's scientific. Decimal places is controlled here, and you can choose how many decimal places you would like, but bear in mind the decimal places, whatever you choose here, will only have an effect if in the formatting you choose a format that accepts decimal places, so that's fixed or standard really, because we're ignoring the money ones as that will be its own data type. Then we have a caption if our field name is too cryptic. We'll make the caption number of children, but I'm going to shorten the field name because it'll be less typing when I need it to childs. Is there a default value for our number of children? Well, we could put zero. If most of the people we know are not going to have children, we might as well already have a zero in there. And then if they do have children, we overtype. So that's a number data type. The notes data type, you'll see, has pretty much the same properties as the text field, except for the length, because you don't control the length, it can be any size, but the rest is the same. If the caption needs to overwrite the field name, we use the caption. Is there a default value? Validation rule and text we'll look at. Is it required? The flag, this is a much shorter field type. We can change its caption and we can set a default value, and the format is either yes, no, true, false, or on, off. What you will find is that in Access, the way that it deals with a yes, no field, true, false, yes, no, on, off, is a tick box. And when it's ticked, that's effectively on or true or yes. And when the tick's not there, that's the same as false, no, or off. So we're going to leave our flag as yes, no. Hyperlink, different field type. Again, same properties here as a text field, except for the length. There's no restriction on how long the text that you enter in your hyperlink field can be. You can see that we need to put some thought into the field properties, and that's best done at the design stage. So when you're drawing up the design of your database tables, as well as deciding the field name and deciding the data type, you need to decide on these field properties. Do I want to control the size of the field? Do I want to add up input mass? Do I want to change the caption so that the label makes more sense than the field name to people using the database? Do I want to set a default value? Is this a required field? All thoughts that should be going through your head and being written down on the design of your database table. That's the field properties per field within your given table. If you make any changes to the field properties as you go, you'll need to then make sure that you save those changes. That's file and save, because you've actually changed the structure of the table.